He was made divine by a vote at the Council of Nicaea in 325 AD, at the insistence of the Roman Emperor Constantine. Constantine pretended to have converted to Christianity, but he was actually a pagan emperor. He made Christianity the official religion of the Roman Empire for political reasons. Jesus' establishment as the Son of God was officially proposed and voted on by the Council of Nicaea. Until that moment in history, Jesus was viewed by his followers as a mortal prophet. Did the Roman Emperor Constantine cherry-pick which Gospels he wanted to be included in the Bible? Dan Brown says that more than 80 Gospels were considered for the New Testament. And he says Constantine commissioned and financed a new Bible, which omitted those Gospels that spoke of Christ's human traits and embellished those Gospels that made him godlike. The earlier Gospels were outlawed, gathered up and burned. And so this is how the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, got into our Bible today.
There is no evidence that Constantine was in a position to choose which Gospels were or were not in the New Testament, because the New Testament by his time was already recognized, and the four Gospels that we have were already part of the New Testament that were received by Constantine and the church of his time. So to suggest that he made a choice as to which books should be in the New Testament or out of it, which Gospels should be included or not, is to portray the situation in a way that isn't consistent with the facts of the case.
There were some Christian leaders who said, well, James, I don't know if we should include him. Now, he's the brother of Jesus. Why wouldn't you want his letter? Because if you read the letter, it doesn't have the gospel that people came to associate with Christianity.
In complete contrast to today's Christianity, the letters of Jesus' brothers describe him as their master, but not divine. They see Jesus as a human character blessed by God.
The thing about the book of James, it's the teachings of Jesus, but not the teachings about Jesus. James passes on what he got from his brother. You could say it has no theology.
The seven stages.
And yet it does have a theology, but it's the theology of Jesus. But it's no theology about Jesus in that book. It doesn't mention the cross of Christ. It doesn't mention the blood of Jesus. Doesn't mention forgiving sins through believing in the Lord, our Savior, who's in heaven. Nothing like that. It's an amazing book to read.
This alternative version of Jesus' message can be found in other texts too. In the Greek quarter of the Old City of Jerusalem, there is another ancient book that was not included in the Bible. It's one of the most contested of early Christian documents, possibly even older than the Gospels themselves. The Library of the Greek Patriarch has the only complete copy of an ancient handbook specially written for converts to Christianity that was compiled when Jesus' family was still alive. The Didache gives a direct insight into what the very earliest Christians thought and did. It has never before been filmed.
Can I hold it?
Yes.
Wow. This is like being close to the early church.
Of course.
Wow.
The Didache, or teaching, contains a code of Christian ethics based on